Hey there, viewer. Welcome back to XCOM 2 Blind Legendary Ironman. This episode, we're going to hack an advent workstation, and it's going to be very difficult. There's also a sectopod on this mission. I checked, because we have that power now, but this time, we're going to be ready to hack it for real. Hopefully. Maybe. Who knows? Let's do this thing. Let's just stop talking, and let's just go. Let's just go. I don't even care where we go. We don't even have to go on the mission. Blood freaking Hill. Okay, sure, yeah, we're just gonna go ahead and hack the train on Blood Hill. That sounds so fun and easy. Well, hopefully with Void Rift it'll be pretty. I don't know what the range of Void Rift is, but I'm hoping to test it out today. It might be pretty sick, it might be really bad, we don't know. I think that mask is, it's like the Phantom of the Opera, but he's the Phantom of the Void Rift. Everybody's got silly outfits. Except TruOne. TruOne's kinda like, sorta professional. It's like, come on guys, keep it real. I'm gonna try to hack a sectopod and fail again. That's what's gonna happen. Alright, let's do it. Hopefully this time we'll get the hack right. We'll see though. We'll see what the towers have for us this time too. Start on the roof, start on the roof, start on the roof, start on the roof. This looks not very roofy.
Menace 1-5, this is Avenger. The access point we're after is just ahead. Move to secure the area. Expect hostile resistance.
No ticket, but that's alright. So the thing we gotta hack's over there. It looks like all the elevations on this side, so this is probably the side I want to stick with. Down here in the middle, I really can't tell. So we're probably gonna move around the train. Just take it from there. Potentially leave it from there as well.
On the move.
This mission's a big one. We cannot fail it. We have to make sure this one does not go through, or else enemies are gonna get detection radii that are much larger than normal,
go.
And that's gonna make me an unhappy super spaz if that ends up being the case. Okay, how is it that you saw the turret, but literally nobody else who just ran near that thing did? I don't get it. I won't understand this ever, I'm sure. It's just one of those things, I guess. Hopefully we'll be able to get up that ladder. Oh, the turret might be able to see us, though, if we do that. If we can hack it, though, I won't worry about it. TruOne probably has the chops to do it at this point.
Solid copy.
I hope. I hope he does. I hope he's got the chops. If he doesn't have the chops, I'm gonna be really pissed. Royally pissed.
In cover.
So super duper pissed that, I don't know, you won't hear it from me, but yeah, that's sectopod noises.
I'm a sectopod, I'm big and scary.
Let's see what chances you got on that. If you have a good chance to hack it, I think we'll just go for it. Even though that might reveal us. I don't know if that reveals us. Does it reveal us? 79% chance to destroy it, or temporarily just disable this thing for sure. I don't know. What are we thinking? If we don't, we have to kill it. And then we get revealed, and then we're in for it. We're cooking with petrol now. Then again, we can just throw a grenade at it, and then blow up its little hidey hole thing. So that's really not a big deal. Now let's just hack it, see if we can control it. Good job. Good job, TruOne. Good job. Here we go. We are cooking with petrol now. Let's see what we see, if anything. Ah, yes, a pod. But of course, we won't activate it until we're done cooking with petrol. But we can get up on the roof. We can get up on this roof and it's okay. Mr. Roboto. Domo arigato. So what do we want to do? What's our game here? I mean, that turret eventually is gonna lose control of itself. We're probably gonna have to get on the floor and walk the dinosaur anyway. So I really don't know what our opening play is here. And it would be really bad if we had to deal with a turret that came back to life. So maybe we should just get out of range of the turret. And see about it from there. So everybody just kind of gets up against this thing to take off this pair. I don't know if the turret reactivates as concealed or not. That's the question that I have. Pretty damn good question. Could try our hand at Void Rift, but I don't know. I'm not sure yet. I'd like to get eyes on that tower, but I don't think I can at this point. TruOne's too far back. Apparently, you can't go anywhere, so why don't we just put you here for now, so you can get on the roof next time. We'll be patient. We'll be patient. We'll see if you catch him. We'll see. Soon enough. I don't know if it counts as a concealed Overwatch or what. I'm kind of confused about it. Whoa, yeah, that's right. I've got a timed goal, don't I? I better get going, huh? I forgot about that little detail. I can't spend all this time setting up. I actually have to make a move or something. Oh, of course you went into cover. That's just fine. That is literally okay. It's not stupid. It's also dumb. Apparently we still have control of it. That's pretty neat. As long as we stay out of range of it, that's okay. What do we want to do? How do we want to open this? What's a way to kill or one-shot these guys? I guess we could throw a flashbang or Void Rift. I wonder what that would do. Have a 4 to 5 damage. That's not a lot of damage. Organic enemies have a chance to suffer insanity. I'd wait on that then. Probably not gonna open with that one. We could potentially. That reveals us to the Jedi. I don't want to reveal myself to the Jedi just yet. What's gonna do the most damage? I don't know if incendiary bombs do anything to Dromedons like that. It's a good question, and I don't know the answer to it. Well, you get an extra action after this, so you can either move or shoot. Maybe we should do this and then just deal with the... can we blow up the tower? Does the tower blow up if we do that? I don't want to blow up the tower. I want to blow up just them. Whoops. Hold on. Alright, yes, I don't like it, but we're gonna have to plasma grenade first, as always. Now, I don't know if this is gonna reveal everything, but if it does, that's okay, we can handle it, I think.
Grenade out!
Oh boy, are we cooking with petrol now. If they cluster, we'll just Void Rift, or something, or throw more grenades. Now we got a critical on him, too bad that doesn't matter.
We're in their sight.
We can serial, if anything, if it goes real bad. Oh, that didn't, oh, hey, that's good. That actually apparently didn't do anything, negative for us. I wonder, if we use the turret, is that gonna reveal to the other ones that the turret is... I wonder how that works. Well, hell, let's figure it out. Yes? Yeah, no, no, that was totally fair. Alright, fine, I'm good with that. I am officially cool with that. Can you see... Now, is there a place you can get, actually, that you can see the turret? That would be nice. I have to move my assault, I think. Well, you may be needed, though. I don't... You're not going to be needed for cereal, but you may be needed to take some shots at this thing if we're not going to kill it in one turn. We'll see about that. So we may as well just reveal you now, right?
I'm on the move.
Oh, I probably should have put you up on top of that. Never mind. It's good, it's good.
Position compromised.
Now let's put you a place where you can see both the turret and the Andromedon. I'm hoping this thing will be dead shortly. We won't have to deal with it for one turn. Probably have to throw a grenade too to get rid of its cover because it's stupid. Alright. What do you get from the tower hack?
Hacking in!
Firstly. Secondly. I mean, if it's something really good, I'd be down for it. Gains control of a random enemy, gains control of all robotic enemies for one turn. That includes sectopods? Let's wait on that one. Because that might be super sexy. Maybe when that turret goes down, we'll use it. Alright, definitely don't want to use your grenade. Don't have another grenade with you. You have a grenade, though. You can definitely, destroy that cover for us. Mr. Little Tiny Rookie Baby. if that's something you're into. I mean, if you don't want to do it, that's okay. I won't blame you. I just would rather keep you out of the path of the Andromedon's wrath. Right? So why don't we just put you down in the middle of nowhere? That seems safe. So I'm not taking a shot with you, and I'm not void rifting, that's for sure. Okay, good. This thing is now easier cheese than it was previously. So let's start chipping this buddy down. Nice shot. That was a really good shot, actually. Oh, wait. Can you shoot it, turret, Mr. Turret? And then take it out of its stupid form? If you can't see it, that's okay. I don't blame you. That's fair game, I guess. All right. I'd rather save that for when we have jazz hands or whatever. Apparently you can see it from there, which is good. Or there, but I think you might be able to see the turret from there, which I don't want. No, apparently not. Oh, it actually doesn't tell me. That's great. Doesn't tell me if I can see the turret. Okay, sure. Sure, don't tell me that.
I'm on it.
Nah, we don't need cover. We'll kill this thing. It'll be dead. That's pretty cool. I like that.
Target neutralized.
All right. We're not gonna waste lightning hands yet. Depending how much power we have here. I honestly don't know. Can you see the turret? The turret is apparently out of range, but with a pistol, if you can shoot the turret with a pistol, we have a problem. Yeah, we have a problem. You're gonna be seen by that thing. We don't want that. That's not okay. Man, dude, no, acid grenade's not gonna do anything, is it? Yeah, I don't know. Are we gonna kill this thing or what? We may have to use lightning hands. Yeah, we may have to use lightning hands, just to be safe. Then if the shotgun gun doesn't kill it, we'll see. Nope, we're gonna have to move it. Probably should have actually done that second. Never mind, it's okay. It is all good in the hood.
I can handle that.
Good. It's got one health left, that's so stupid. No, not pistol overwatch. I want you to fire your pistol and kill it, please.
Well, how about that?
Moving to overwatch.
That thing's gonna lose control. Do we just have permanent control? What's the deal? I don't think that's true, right? Uh-oh, they noticed. Well, the turret noticed, too. That's good. Good miss, maybe. Dumbass. Alright, it's okay. Domarigato, Mr. Roboto? What do you think, TruOne? If you hack that thing... So I guess we don't lose control of it. That's kind of funny. Not like haha funny, but it's kind of funny how that's happening. Okay, sure. I'll roll with it. Now, you're probably not going to be able to shoot them this turn, which is okay, I don't
care. What's over there?
But we may need you to hack that thing so we get control of a sectopod for a turn, depending on how that goes. I mean, what's the penalty for missing this hack, by the way? If it's a feedback effect, I probably won't do it. And it's only like a 50-50 shot at this point. Yeah, I don't want the reinforcements yet, not while we're in the middle of combat. There's no reason to summon that, that sort of trouble on my back right now. Now, Vic Vega can't do much. You might be able to toss a grenade out, or an incendiary grenade, depending on what I can get away with. I don't know where we can throw this thing. This might actually be pretty good. But I don't think we can throw it very far. I'm gonna take a wild guess and say no, that's not gonna happen this turn. So we might just have to overwatch and then deal with the consequences as they come. Which is never fun, by the way. Especially if that Archon can reach us. 55 on the Archon, 54 on you, 50 on the Muton. Should probably just focus fire on the Muton, right? That might be best. I mean, even though the Archon is technically the easiest to hit, eh, I guess I worry about him the most. Might prevent them from moving too if I overwatch. We might be able to hold our ground here.
I'm going.
If we just overwatch everybody, we're not gonna get any. This is very interesting.
Come get some.
Got it covered.
Come get some.
I don't think I've had this problem yet. Where I've had to overwatch trap like this.
Whatever you say. On overwatch.
Maybe good to actually throw the mimic. Well, I don't know if the mimic beacon's gonna do as much good, to be honest. Sorry for the sniffles. What would really suck Nards is if I accidentally activated another pod by just going this one tile that way, but that doesn't. Oh, but I hear it. I hear it. It's probably on top of that building. Yeah, we gotta get over that train quick. I think we'll make it in 8 turns.
Maintain position.
Uh oh. Well, that's not great. So it was like just not that many. It was some turns we got it, but not that many. Well, that's not great. Good try. We'll see.
Yeah, I didn't get it.
Good shot, actually. Ah, it's the Majestic Archon. Good hits. I like it. I like the hits. Man, this thing is hurting. What the hell? What in God's name? Should we move, or do we just get hit? I think we move. I think the deal is we gotta move. Good miss, but not really.
Target's still up.
He's blazing. We're gonna throw a grenade on that after we move, of course. The Overwatch is clever. I'll give him that. And you marked me. Good job. Good job, asshats. You did a real good job. I'm impressed, even, some might say. It's all right. Now, we won't see that thing on Overwatch. Is there anywhere you can move where you're not gonna trigger that thing's asshole Overwatch? Apparently not here. The Archon's a problem, yes. I'll grant you that one. But, it's a problem we can fix. I just need to get right out of the way of the pinions or whatever. The Funyuns. The Blazing Funyuns.
On your order!
Those aren't fun. Hi, Palo. Yeah, you're gonna die this turn. Don't worry about that. That's not a problem for me. That turret and that Muton are going down. The Archon's going down. If I have anything to say about it. I mean, everyone just goes down if I get my way. Alright, good. What are we thinking? That will apparently just kill the shit out of the Archon. I like that, because A, it's probably gonna be really hard to hit. 80% straight up hit that thing, but I don't think it's gonna happen. Let's get you up and running in the front. Hey, if you get them with a acid grenade, they'll both die. I don't wanna waste an acid grenade, but it's like, probably need that for the, ooh, but I wonder. And now I wonder if I can void rift. How far can I void rift? That's far. That's obscenely far. Sure. Why not? Nobody's on Overwatch. Why not get you some psychic
no problem, boss.
Psychic kills now, since you're gonna get pinioned or funioned or whatever. Let's just kill them both. 4 to 5. That won't kill the Muton, but we can kill him other ways.
The rift will set you free.
The truth will set you free, or something. I think you get more damage as you rank up psi-wise. Wait, what's happening? You hit them twice? Oh, you panicked him. Oh, that's good. That means he's useless now. Or he's gonna shoot his friends. Oh, yes, I love it. Thank you, Mr. Muton. Thank you, Muton friend. Okay, let's combat protocol the flaming pinions here. Maybe they won't happen if I do that. That would be nice. Flaming funions. Oh, that's not great. I take it there's nothing I can do about that one. That's cool. Now I wonder if I get pistol shots from this.
Whatever you say.
Okay, guess not. That's all right though. Good hit. Maybe we can finish him off with the assault for lucky. Oh, look. The Funyuns came to us. Well, that's just that's just dandy. I think that Muton's not going to do anything next turn if he's panicked. But in case, I'm going to cover myself against him, so that doesn't happen. Let's get you rolling. That did not kill you, surprisingly. You're still standing, which is impressive. Why can't I search the loot? It says I can, but I can't. I'm confused. I don't want to move too far forward, you know what I mean? It's kind of dangerous, and I think an 80% chance to hit kill that guy is pretty good, so I'm gonna go for it. We don't have to worry about the flaming Funyuns anymore. Yeah. So let's get ready to kill that Muton when the time comes, when the time is right. I don't know what the range on the flaming Funyuns is, actually. If it blows up, like, or it's just like a pin missile. Like a pinpoint kind of deal. Okay, I'm just gonna end the turn and maybe it'll just let me go. Oh, I'm sorry. Did what happen now? Oh, that blows up the whole roof. Cool. Didn't know that. But now I do, I guess. That's fun. So I guess everybody just took a dick ton of damage. That's nice. That really makes me happy. Well, you took like 2 damage, but then you almost died from that. That is some righteous bullshit right there. Who's gonna take out that thing? Speaking of which, we actually should get going. Like, we should get moving forward here. Maybe we should try for the hack. I don't know if we'll make it or not. I really just need to get eyes on it in the future, and I think if we blow up that wall, we should be able to with TruOne. So maybe I'll move here, try the hack, and then if we get control of all robotic enemies, or a random robotic enemy, I think a random robotic enemy for 2 turns might be better than all of them for 1 turn.
Infiltrating access point.
Because then I can just wreak havoc with that sectopod and have a fun, sexy time, you know what I mean? It's a much higher, or just a random enemy. Eh, screw it, let's do it. Yeah, definitely a good idea to do that one. Not a robotic enemy, but just a random enemy for 2 turns, that's good. I'll take it.
I'm in.
What did I mind control? What did I get? Not that, I guess. I got the thing that wasn't the sector. Okay, that's gonna be fun to deal with in the future. Well, Agent Croque, I guess you should probably just try to kill that thing, if possible, by getting up close to it and shooting it in the face. And then everybody else will just kind of move on forward. I don't know how you feel about it, but I feel pretty good about this. How many pods was that? That was 1 pod, 2 pod, 3 pod. This is the 4th pod, so there's probably a 5th pod out there. You have a 45% chance to kill him, really. No, I don't like that. No, it worked. It worked, though.
Hostile target down.
Okay. Apparently you can see. Oh, that's sexy. I mean, your squad sight range makes it really, really unlikely you're even gonna hit him. And there's no roof anymore. But, more power to you, I guess. Now, let's move the squad up as 1 here. Maybe I'll just take pot shots at the sectopod. Who knows? That's actually pretty alright with me. Since there is an activated pod, I'd like to keep everybody in cover.
I can handle that.
Good copy. Moving on target.
Hell, do you just want to try and do that then? Just take pot shots at that thing? Is that smart? I don't know. I mean, there's no consequences for it, so why not? Good try.
Get it together.
Well, at least that enemy's gonna get fried.
Affirmative, covering now.
Moving to Overwatch.
I mind controlled him and yet he didn't do anything. That's kind of embarrassing for him because he's gonna die. Oh, he's getting tall. Big and tall. Oh, that's super duper sad. Alright, they're moving in. They're gonna try to kill me.
They're flanking my position.
which I'm not a fan of. And that Sectobot is on its way. Well, how do we deal with that? I guess we keep trying to get forward and do some hacking business. We might want to throw out a Mimic Beacon, if possible.
All right,
if I can see the goal, that would be great. We can do it. On what? On what do you have this authority? How can you do this? Apparently the Sectobot. Apparently you can try.
Try not to break this one.
I'm down to try it. I mean, we got nothing to lose if it's inside that building. I think that is it. I think that's the Sectobot. Shutdown. Let's do a shutdown. What is it with you and Sectobots, TruOne? You got some serious issues with those, and I don't think I like them. Mimic Beacons for sure. They're going down. You're not mind controlled at all. That's not, that's just blatantly false. Now you have a much higher chance to hit it now.
Moving to position.
Let's get you into cover and reload. You're probably not gonna be much good out here anyway. What about you? You wanna acid grenade everybody involved?
Here I come.
I like that idea. We can hit. Oh, we can, I think. Why, yes, I believe we can do that. Yes, I believe I'm gonna do. Oh, wait. Wait, why am I mind controlling this guy? Why is this guy mind controlled all of a sudden? That doesn't make any goddamn sense. No, just. Nah, just acid them. It's okay. No, I don't care that we suddenly have mind control. I guess it's because our unit got killed, but I don't get that at all. Okay, so everyone involved is not doing so hot. I'd like to get some extra sauce or something going. Cereal's not gonna do us much good. It's gonna be good to have the Mimic Beacon out against that stupid Sectobot anyway.
Moving to designated position.
Hi. And then you toss the Mimic Beacon, how's that sound? Sounds pretty sexy to me. Hopefully the Sectobot sees the Mimic Beacon.
Seems doable.
And falls for its bullshit. It'll probably see it there. Okay. Well, I guess why not keep trying to hit it? I don't know. We got a better chance this time. Good shot. That was beautiful.
Hard target. Minimal damage.
That thing is scurry. Good try. Not really.
Shot wide.
You're mind controlled for whatever reason. I don't understand. And all the science I don't understand. It's just my job 5 days a week. Oh, hi. Speaking of our job 5 days a week, here's some more enemies for us to deal with. Well, that's a very unsexy position. If only I hadn't tried to haywire protocol this asshole, we'd be okay. Good lord. You're just here, aren't you? And you get two shots, apparently. Two shots. I love it. It's so fair and sexy. Or infinite shots, maybe. Yeah, you're still alive, though. That's all I care about. You're gonna do one last heroic act before you go. Okay. Now what? Shua might want to get our... Lucas Victor might want to get our... Not Lucas Victor. None of those names make any sense. You're gonna have to get out here and start firing your pistol, perhaps. Or, well, depending on what shot your sniper has against that thing, you're gonna blue screen round it, for sure. Oh, hey! I wonder if they are immune to fire. That's a good question. I wonder if I can even take that thing out with all its armor, is another good question. I wonder if I can insanity 80% chance to do it. That's pretty good. 8 to 10 damage on a stun lance on that thing? Boy, howdy. What are we thinking? I mean, hell. That's pretty neat. That'd be a cool self-sacrificial thing to do. Why not do it? Go for it, pal. I believe in you. So what just happened? I'm confused. All right. We have another maybe beacon in case things go utterly wrong. Let's toss an incendiary grenade out. Why not? I don't think it'll do anything to the robots, but it might.
On the move.
Might make things a bit easier for us, for the organic enemy at least. Who do we want to catch on fire? These two?
Grenade out!
I don't know if fire does anything to robots, but we'll find out, won't we? It does! It does do things to robots. And apparently shreds their armor too, which is really fair seeming. And what about this asshole? Do we want to try and get that guy on the roof? Or do we just want to use a mimic beacon, honestly? I think that might just be better. Because this big guy over here is a problem. That big guy over there is a problem. Let's just take care of the problem the only way we know how. Of course, that's going to make it harder for us to deal with the, to get to the device, but we might be able to do it in 4 turns, I think.
Catch!
And we get another action with her anyway, so that's pretty good. So that guy should just be straight up maybe dead. I'm not sure at this point. He's burning and acided, so it's a good question. Just shoot it. Should have shredded his armor, don't you, Shredder? What is this bull? What is this bull honky? You can't insanity anymore, but you can shoot, which is all I really care about. Ah, hell, rookie. Why not shoot? That's why, rookie, that's why. It's okay, rookie. Don't feel bad about doing a bad job. You were obviously gonna do it anyway. So that thing's probably gonna die. I'm not really sure, though. That thing I want dead. So if I can just shoot that, that'd be great. I don't have to waste time with my mimic beacon here. Though I do need that sectopod kill, don't I? And Wildman, oh no, you're left too. So you might be able to kill it. Let's see about that. If you can hit it. You would guaranteed kill that thing. Yeah, try to take out that thing on the top there. Great! Good shooting, Tex.
Impressed yet?
No, but keep trying. So that guy's gonna die to acid. So if I can guaranteed kill the sectopod, we might not actually have to use the mimic beacon. Or if I can get cereal going, I can get a cereal chain racked up.
Ready for more.
I may just not care. 100% chance? Love it. Let's do it. Oh, that's gonna blow up a lot. Oh, but good, just good enough. Just good. It's all good. Everybody's happy.
Affirmative. Moving out.
Affirmative. Moving out. Yeah, hell, why not? Blow his brains out. Good. Great. That was something.
Positive confirmation.
That's a way to go.
Area secured.
Oh, area secured. All right, we have all the time in the world to get to this device now. We have to get through acid and whatnot, but that's workable. We can do that. We can make it happen if we believe in ourselves. Or not.
Is it clear?
So how are we gonna get to that device? They really didn't plan this far ahead. Maybe I should blow up the walls around it. That might work.
Eyes on the target.
Ah, perfect.
Commander, we have confirmation of the exposed access point.
All right. Why don't we go ahead and no, you're not ready. It's okay. You can take another turn, I guess.
Overwatch. I'm on it.
Finally.
Whatever you say.
Let's catch up to the squad for no particular reason. I mean, there is actually no particular reason. We're done here, except for that goal. Slash objective, slash... God damn it. Stupid roof. I didn't know it was going to blow up that bad. I thought the little Pinot Noir nuts was going to be a little less intense than that. That's okay. Let's go ahead and get right snuggled up against that device. Hack it. Just hack it. Hack it silly, TruOne. And for the love of God, don't fail. Whatever extra reward we get. Delays current dark events by 2 weeks, reduces contact costs for nearby regions. Yeah, you know what? Yes, do that one. Because I don't want more dark events than we can handle right now. And we wouldn't have made that anyway. Alright, sweet. TruOne's gonna get these sectopods one day, I promise.
We've got access!
Status confirmed. Mission sweet. Accomplished.
And I'll bet now, what's his face is Agent Croque is like out for years. That's alright, we have a backup, but still, stupid. Stupid and also dumb. Sectopods ain't, they're not even that bad yet. I haven't faced one without mimic beacons yet. I did kill that one in one turn though. I got the achievement for it, that's how I know. So that was nice. So that was a good feeling. How long? 9 days, that's not even bad. Wow, lightly wounded one day. You got your final promotion, didn't you? Well, oh. So Reaper's the blade one, right? Chain melee attack, so you're probably not gonna spec into that. But you are gonna spec into rapid fire. Fire twice in a row at an enemy. Each shot suffers an aim penalty of minus 15. There's no cooldown for this ability. But I'm definitely gonna go over that over Reaper, because you're not built for Reaper. So let's do rapid fire. Sweet. Alright, so he is a full-on, full-fledged, max-power assault right now. And that is just fine with me. Let's continue. So he's the first one to actually reach max rank. That's interesting. It wasn't Ancrath and it wasn't Vic Vega. Probably because they've both been wounded so much.
Hello, Commander.
And we would delay those dark events, so it's actually going to be even smoother sailing than I thought. What dark events are active right now? None, I think we got it. Not now. Do we need intel? We do, but I want to finish the bonfire. And then maybe start building some things here. Let's finish bonfire.
Avenger plotting,
and then we'll build
course.
A radio relay with our Dosh. And then we'll probably have to deal with an admin facility. Or, yeah, I was right.
Commander, if we want to
That's
set back
okay.
the aliens' work
days.
On the Avatar project, we should hit one of their facilities as soon as possible.
What can we do right now? What can we buy? What's the dealio? Powered armor in 9 days. I want to save up for that, but we don't have the Illyrium for it. We do have the alloys, I think. So if there's a way we can get more Illyrium, probably the black market, I have to say. So we do need more intel. I am right. I am correct in saying that we do need more intel.
I've got to hand it to the aliens. The invasion was one thing. All their advanced technology.
Maybe upgrade the power relay eventually. Sure. Shadow Chamber doesn't get...
But Advent, there's something we could never have prepared for, even with better gear.
Is that so?
Between the propaganda, the handouts, and a seemingly endless supply of reinforcing peacekeepers, they're nothing but trouble for an upstart resistance movement.
Commander, the Shadow Chamber is up and running. All we have to do now is put it to use.
I think we're more than just upstarts right now, Bradford. I think we're full on... full-blown threats. Let's get that
Avenger
intel.
Avenger plotting new course.
We are full-blown aides to these Advent chumps right now, and they are struggling to find a cure. Hell, even a treatment. They thought sectopods were it, but they weren't. All right. I'm not going to do anything with that right now, because really nothing else is of importance. I can just upgrade the resistance comms, and I can upgrade power, so I don't actually need to get more. So let's put Jin Kamiya and Morna Apollon on that, start excavating, and we'll finally have all the rooms cleared out. And then we can just decide what to do with them later. And that was some extra money I needed, so good. Maybe even a few Illyriums.
Strategic resource located.
Okay. Now let's go to the black market, maybe buy some Illyrium. Unless I already did that and I
Avenger
forgot.
Plotting new course.
But intel's always nice to have. And then we're probably going to go on a facility mission. Maybe not next. Nope, we already did that. Okay, never mind. It's okay. We don't care. We can heal faster if we want. But I want to build radio towers for the next drop. Unless that's too soon. It is too soon. That's okay. 4 days. Oh yeah, and I'm retraining Mr. Krebs to do an experimental sort of thing. Domination in 3 days, that's good. That'll give him even more psi powers to use. Then, Shall we get the Eastern U.S. some extra money?
Setting course for Eastern United States.
We're almost spanning the globe here. But then we're probably going to hit up Australia next, because that's where the... Oh, 3 days? Oh, we're going to make it then? Maybe? We'll see. Oh, snap. What should you get next? Stasis, Solus. Okay, let's see. Soulfire does guaranteed psionic damage to an organic enemy. Ignores cover and armor. Nice. Stasis completely stuns the target for one turn, but renders them immune to any damage or attack. That's actually pretty good if you're trying to avoid being killed by something, like if you just stand out in the middle of nowhere. Psioperative is surrounded by an aura that immediately extinguishes or blocks any mental impairments for themselves or any nearby squadmates. I think I might go with Stasis, because that actually sounds pretty useful for emergency things. Soulfire is nice. Maybe I should do Soulfire, because that would be more damage. Soulfire is pretty good damage. I can train another soldier. Ooh. Oh, no, I can't. Oh, I have to unlock an upgrade to get a second. I don't really need a second. Let's do Stasis, maybe. I think that's good. Yeah. Let's check him out. What's he like on his tree? So yeah, he already got Void. Wow, he got the two highest ability, like some of the two highest abilities on right off the bat. That's crazy. Wow, that's cool. 71 Psi. He's got some pretty good Psi. If only there were a Psi PCS, that would be great. We got Insanity. Oh, I guess that's like the default ability, but he unlocked Insanity as his default ability. I don't know how it works. We haven't done anything yet. And I don't know where, but I think Psy Operatives can unlock all their abilities potentially if they just keep training, which is what we're gonna try to do. And then he's just gonna be unstoppable eventually. We should be good in one day. So let's just keep swimming. Hopefully we'll get upgraded armor before we have to assault the next base, which would be really cool.
Through clear.
Sweet. Armor and vest ground projects are completed instantly, which means I can complete exosuits as fast as I want. But I'm not going to do that, because I'm going to complete the next thing, which I think is the war suit, in 3 days. Which is going to be really cool. 3 days till experimental ammo. Yeah. If I want to spend an Illyrium core, I can get some experimental armor for no reason, because I never use armor. Maybe that's stupid, but hey. I'm down with stupid. Let's keep scanning. Let's do something worth scanning, though. I mean, I need money. We're getting the supply drop, so it's kind of be stupid to start installing radio relays places I don't need them. Maybe I should install... Oh, no, I don't need a radio relay there. I can't make contact there yet. Oh, apparently I can directly make contact with Australia from somewhere. Oh, no, I can't. I don't have any of the places required to do that, so I won't. Yeah, I need a couple more contacts. So I guess I just need to spend money on my resistance comms. But I need another engineer to do that. How about we don't yet? How about we wait on that? We'll do that. Let's just go back and heal faster.
Setting course for East Asia.
I mean, the supply drop's gonna come in as soon as we start anyway, so it's not a big deal. And then I'll even have more black market stuff to get.
Incoming message for you, Commander. Patching it through to your quarters now.
Your progress against the aliens over the past month has been significant, Commander. But there is still room to improve if we are going to eliminate the alien threat.
Ooh, that's different. So we counted those by 2 weeks. That's good. 4 weeks, so a month until the next retaliation strike in December. But hopefully we'll be on the road to victory by then. After armor, I might go for a few more autopsies, and then we're going to hit up all the Shadow Chamber projects and advance the story here. That kind of sucks. But I don't care about retaliation strikes. They're kind of easy. If you have a good squad, that is. I definitely want to get rid of the brute strength one. That's pretty stupid. All right, let's get that those supplies. Hopefully get some dank armor. And maybe, just maybe, if we're lucky... when is armor done? 3 days? I don't know if we'll make it 3 days. Nope, we didn't make it 3 days. We have to rescue a VIP from an advent cell. Dr. Karen Hartman is another scientist. We don't need scientists, really. Guess, maybe. Doesn't seem that difficult, though. And I do see Sectapod, though. Maybe TruOne will hit it this time. Maybe he'll get it this time. We'll see. And lead officer, advent mech, archon, viper. So all the usual stuff. I don't think we've seen vipers in a while. But Andromedon, yeah, we're used to those by now. Sectopods, I haven't had too much trouble with. Shield bearers, yeah, this is nothing new. All right, let's go.
Setting course for the Arctic.
Let's finish this. Let's finish these advent chumps. I'm ready to go. All right, let me gear up a squad and I'll see you on the other side. All right, here is the squad for this mission, Operation Bleeding Feast. It's gonna be difficult, but we're gonna rescue Dr. Karen Hartman. So I expect 4 pods, maybe a drop-in, and it's gonna be, there's gonna be a sectopod there and we're all gonna have a happy, fun time. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and if you did, maybe, if it's in your heart, leave a like. I don't know. They say, you know, people get mad when you ask to do that, but also it is shown that it does improve. I don't know. I guess it doesn't really matter, right? Because I'm just doing this for, I don't know. I like to see that you guys appreciate what I do, and I can tell. I don't know. I'm just talking aloud. Anyway, thank you for watching. It means a lot to me, and I'll see you next time. Later.